Hey everyone. Happy Monday. Happy belated Groundhog Day. Happy day after the Super Bowl. And happy February. I'm going to be streaming some more Spelunky for approximately the next 2.5 hours. And I hope you enjoy it. The music selection tonight is the soundtrack to Kirby's Epic Yarn. Really fantastic soundtrack. I can't give you a link to download it legally like I could the last couple streams, but if you go to YouTube and just search Kirby's Epic Yarn soundtrack, you can enjoy it pseudo-legally. If you want to bet on how I'm going to die, go to dukeofthebump.com/bet and play Spelunky Roulette. I'm, as usual, I'm going to be doing a few, just general practice hell attempts, and then in a couple hours I will be attempting the daily challenge, and it should be a good old time. Hello Tarka in the chat room, and hello Galen as well. Glad you guys can make it. I just unlocked this guy a few days ago, this gruff looking fellow. I did a run where I went to the Haunted Castle level, and the coffin actually had a character in it, not just a generic hired hand. So I'll be trying him out. You know, I like to change things up a little bit. I haven't talked to this guy in a while, Tunnel Man. I appreciate your efforts, Tunnel Man, but don't really need you. Sorry, dude. Hello, Kostya and Enzu Draragna in the chat room. I know I always probably say your names wrong, and I apologize if that's the case. I'll be locking bets around the end of the mines if I last that long, which hopefully I will. So make sure you get your bets in before then if you want to play along. Just call me Taz. Oh, are you Tazarin? I think I made the connection between your names at some point, but I forgot. I apologize. And I apologize for canceling the last stream a few days ago. I was feeling a little bit under the weather. I would like to stream a little bit more often, but unfortunately, I don't always know exactly when I'll be able to, so I might not be able to make the announcement a day or so ahead of time like I usually try to. So, you know, if you want up-to-the-date stream information, I highly recommend joining the Duke of the Bump Steam group. That's steamcommunity.com/groups/thebump. Or just go to dukeofthebump.com and there is a link there. I should probably make a redirection URL, like dukeofthebump.com/steam or something, just to make things easier. Don't go to that site. There's nothing there right now, but there might be by the time this goes up on YouTube. Ah, crap. So, for those of you who aren't aware, who might not live in the area, Groundhog Day is a North American tradition where we pull a groundhog out of its home February 2nd of every year, and according to tradition, if the groundhog sees his shadow when we pull him out that day, then there will be 6 more weeks of winter, or the other way around. I always forget. Either whether he sees his shadow or not determines how much more winter there will be, but I don't remember the exact rules of the supposed prediction. But what I wasn't aware of until I looked it up, is that there are actually multiple groundhogs in the U.S. and Canada, and, you know, they all have conflicting predictions, so the one most people think about when they think about Groundhog Day, and the one featured in the movie Groundhog Day starring Bill Murray, which is a really cool movie, is Punxsutawney Phil, who lives in Pennsylvania, and he predicted 6 more weeks of winter. But there are also a bunch of groundhogs who predicted an early spring. So, you know, I don't know who to believe. There's one groundhog in Quebec, or Quebec, who's just named Dave, who predicted an early spring. And I think that's pretty cool. I think I will trust Dave on this one. Because, I mean, come on, are you going to trust a guy named Punxsutawney Phil? What kind of, I mean, who does he think he is? I don't go around announcing myself, introducing myself as Charleston Duke, just because I live in Charleston. I mean, for one, my real name is not Duke, but, you know, that just seems a little bit conceited. So, Dave, I'm going to take your word for it on this one. Duke wanted to say that the Steam group is awesome for knowing when you stream. Yep. Kostya is correct on this one. I, highly recommend the Steam group to anyone who, crap. Got a little bit... Oh, man. Didn't even see that bat. I was hoping the updated HUD would be out by the next time I stream. The new HUD is a lot less intrusive than the current one, and it also has some additional information, like the time in the current level, and the overall time, which is pretty. It'd be pretty nice to have that, so I know, you know, about how long I have to wait for the ghost and all that. But I guess that patch isn't ready yet. Pro jump that I just made there. Charleston Matt, yeah. Alright. Early Kapala. I have a good feeling about this run. It's been a week of ups and downs for me as far as Spelunky goes. I had a few days there where I had a bunch of really, really bad runs in a row. And, I'm not gonna lie, it was a little bit frustrating. I got a little bit discouraged because it seems like I had a huge backslide in my level of skill. But, I mean, basically what happened was I was getting cocky, and Spelunky was punishing me for my hubris. I was like, hey, I made it to Yama, I must be pretty hot shit. And I was playing a lot less carefully than I should. So, I dialed it back a little bit, and I've been playing more carefully. And I've had a few really good runs the past couple days. I made it to Yama a second time, and I came pretty close to taking him out. Oh, fuck's sake. That was not me not being careful. That was... Okay, it was. I shouldn't have thrown the rock in that particular arc. But yeah, I think me making it to Yama on stream is becoming more and more of a possibility. I don't want to jinx it, but I've been playing... Ah, crap. I'm going to have to use a rib to get out of here. I've been playing pretty well, so let's cross our fingers. I also had a string of really pathetically embarrassing daily challenges, and my average on the leaderboards just plummeted. It's pretty horrible. I was having a good run last night when I was doing, well, it's technically today's daily challenge, but I was having a really good run. I made it to the black market, and then something, I don't know what, but something pissed off the shopkeepers before I was ready, and I ended up dying to a shopkeeper in the black market. And I don't know what it was. I did not bomb close enough to their shop to piss them off. I don't think there was a frog that blew up or anything. At least I didn't hear an explosion. And I watched a stream of someone else doing that daily challenge, and it didn't happen to them. So I don't know what happened. But, you know, I'm not going to get discouraged. We all have bad runs. And bad strings of runs. Alright, into the mines. We're going to lot the bets. Assuming everyone got their bets in. Yep, Tarka, Galen, and Kostra. Alright, Ooh. Two crates over there. That's well worth spending a bomb to get in. So how's everyone doing? I haven't seen you guys in about a week. And like I said, I would like to start streaming more often. So hopefully I'll be able to see you guys a couple times a week instead of just once a week, or possibly more. Really, it just depends on how busy I am and, you know, how much I feel like streaming. I'm not going to explore this level anymore. I love it when the Mantrap eats one of the shopkeepers. The shopkeeper gives no fucks. Really glad that doesn't make the shopkeepers mad. Seems like it would, since they get mad at pretty much everything else. Got some nice chill music going tonight. This is one of my favorite video game soundtracks of the last few years. I listen to it pretty regularly. It's also just over 2.5 hours, so it's the perfect length for one of these streams. Oh crap. I was all set to throw another bomb, but I did not realize I was out of bombs. Man, there aren't really that many bombs on this level either. That kind of sucks. Oh well, I'll get more. Aw man, I should have bought some health from that dog first. Oh well, I have 7 and the Kapala, so I'm doing pretty okay. Hey Kibitz, just saw the notification in your Gmail. Well, what I recommend is joining the Steam group, assuming you use Steam, and you'll get a pop-up notification whenever the stream goes live. It's pretty convenient. Of course, you don't have to, but it's a little more reliable method of being notified. Aw, man. Oh, crap. Oh, Jesus. The hell away from me. Alright. probably look at the chat when things are a little less precarious. See if I can just lure him out of there. I don't want to have to waste another bomb. Ah, man. Spending too much time here. Maybe I can... Oh, no. I spend way too many bombs if I try to just bomb my way through. Oh, God. Fuck off. I really want those bombs, but... I'm not playing it safe with that ghost. Whew! Been playing Might and Magic X Legacy recently. Really good game for people who like old-style RPGs with tile-based movement, I recommend. Oh, you know what? I forgot to sync up the damn chat room. Oh, damn. Let me let him do that again. There. The Twitch notification is slow. It's 6:15 a.m. at the moment. Wow. That's it's pretty early for a stream. I mean, I wake up that early, but I actually wake up a little bit earlier than that, but, you know, I'm getting ready for work. Alright, that was a pretty good Blood Market run. I would have liked to get a few more bombs, but I feel okay about that. I hate the Tiki Villages. That's what this level layout is. It's called a Tiki Village. I don't know if that's the official name for it. Or if that's just what, well, it probably doesn't have an official name, but, I learned a little trick for helping to deal with these guys in this kind of situation. If you lay down one bomb and then quickly lay down another bomb, then the second bomb should fall down. Straight down. Nah, I probably laid the second one down too fast. Oh well. I should probably just run for it. Hello, Ephraim. So I thought I finished Super Mario 3D Land, which is the other game I've been playing on the 3DS. It's my laundromat game. I made it to the end of World 8. And I beat the last boss. And, turns out that once you beat that game, there are 8 more worlds for you to complete. Basically, an entire other game after the end of the game. Which kind of blew my mind. I mean, it wasn't a super long. Ooh, jetpack. Yes. It wasn't like. I wasn't dissatisfied with the length of the game. I thought it was a little bit short, but I didn't feel like I got ripped off or anything. And then beat World 8. 8 more worlds. And these levels seem a lot more interesting than the main default worlds in the game. It's kind of nuts. I wonder if 3D World on the Wii U is the same way. Oh, is that Might and Magic X or Might and Magic 10? I don't really know much about the Might and Magic games. The only one I have experience with is Clash of Heroes, which I streamed once mainly because I didn't really have anything else to stream at the time. I really love that game, but I understand that none of the other games in the series are anything like that one. That's the kind of puzzle quest style match 3 RPG. But you know, the mechanics are more they're deeper than like Bejeweled or Puzzle Quest or something. It's a really excellent game. Ten equals X, gotcha. Alright, we got a Moai head here, so we're free to explore a little bit. And really lucky, well, I'm really glad I lucked out and got a jetpack in that one shop. I haven't had a jetpack in many of my runs recently. Seems like it's popping up a little bit less frequently. Oh god. Onk? Hello? Well, that's never happened before. Man, what the hell? I was having a good run. Did it just crash? It froze up or something. I don't know what happened. Huh. Well, that is a real pain in the ass. Okay, well, I'm not gonna count that as a death. Wait. Oh, no. Man, what the hell? Like, it paused. Oh well. Being frozen and falling to your death apparently freezes the game. Yeah, apparently. Well, it doesn't freeze it. It just doesn't activate the Ankh. Oh. Yeah, I mean, I bet. I bet since I'm frozen, it doesn't actually recognize that my sprite fell into the abyss or something? I don't know. But then I should have been able to at least pause it. That's weird. Okay, well, I'm unlocking the bets, so if any of you want to change or add bets, well, you can't change your bet, but if you want to bet for more things, then go ahead. I'm not going to count that one. Man, that's really frustrating. But you know, with music this cheerful, I just can't get that mad. Alright, well, back on the horse, I guess. Man, that's a real, bummer. So yeah, Mario 3D Land, highly recommended for anyone with a 3DS. I was all set to get the new Zelda game. Okay, game. You screwed me, but you made up for it. I was all set to get A Link Between Worlds as my next Laundromat game, but now I have an entirely new Mario game to beat, which is pretty exciting. Yeah, they're talking about games in the chat room that I know absolutely nothing about. But it's okay. I don't have to know everything about everything. So that's all I've been doing video game wise is tons of Spelunky and lots of Mario. Well, not lots of Mario, but a good bit of Mario. I did pick up a board game, well, a card game recently that's really cool. It's the Pathfinder Adventure card game. I heard a lot of people say a lot of good things about it, so I picked that up. It is a cooperative 1-4 player, it's hard to describe. It's like a deck building RPG, sort of. Like, your character is represented by a deck of cards containing items and spells and powers and stuff. And a character card. Each character has its own unique abilities. And you race against time to complete an objective. There are adventure cards with scenarios. That one, okay. That trap already fired. And only got to play one game so far, and it went pretty slowly because we were still learning it, but once we picked it up, it seemed pretty easy to get the hang of, and it was a lot of fun. I really like the idea of cooperative board games and card games. Like, I'm a big fan of Pandemic, the board game, where you are a group of scientists and other professionals trying to put a stop to a horrible plague that's going to kill everyone in the world if you can't stop it. That's a really fun one. But yeah, so far, based on the game that I played, Pathfinder card game gets my seal of approval. Good Lord, Steam, is it so hard to let me join a group? Is it just loading forever or what? I noticed Steam was going pretty slowly for me earlier. I don't have a group for board or card games though, sadly. I have just a group of friends I play board games and card games with couple times a month. Family members, really. Moore's is one of them. Ah, crap. But, you know, there might be something in your area you can join. I'm not sure where you live, but, you know, check online. There, meetup.com is a good place to find a group of gamers, or if there's nothing on there, you know, start one. Start a meetup. Say, you know, we're going to play board games at this location every, you know, one day a month or whatever. See if you can get people to join. I want to wait for this mouse because I don't want to have to waste a rope setting off this trap. Thud. Or, you know, if there's a game store in your area, just drop by sometime. In my experience, there's usually, you know, people looking for a game. Well, I can either block that damsel in or waste another bomb. I'm doing pretty good on health, so. Sorry, miss. Hopefully another spelunker will come by who's not quite so stingy with the bombs. But I mean, you know, you've been there this long, you can wait a little bit longer. Moores is your relative. Yes, he's my cousin. Surprise, that's not, I don't know if I've ever mentioned that or not in a video or stream or whatever. Ah, come on. There we go. Well, this run isn't going quite as good, quite as well as the previous one because I don't have the Kabbalah. But at least I have the jetpack and a good amount of health. And of course I don't have the spike boots or... Well, I was going to say the spring boots, but I guess if you have the jetpack, you don't really need those. Man, this guy looks super serious. He's like the opposite of the purple lady I usually play. You know, she's having a good old time. She's on a wild adventure. This guy's seeking the Holy Grail or something. I don't know. He's on an extremely important mission, and nothing will interrupt him. Nothing will get in his way. Aw, man. Freaking spiders. I think I've gotten a lot better about not killing unnecessary enemies. Like those spiders. Forget them. They're not gonna cause me any grief down the line. Ooh, I see secret. Excellent. Oh crap. Just had to ruin my good time, didn't you, Frog? Ah, man. Oh well. There's probably going to be a kissing booth in the black market. There usually is, it seems like, so I can buy up some more health before I piss the shopkeepers off forever. I've gotten a little bit better about being able to deal with the shopkeepers. Like, I figured out a method for robbing them, even if I don't have any items or anything. And, only taking 1 point of damage in the process. Of course, there were a bunch of games where I died to the shopkeeper in the mines. Because, they tend to be harder to deal with than in any other area of the game. But, I've gotten a better handle on it, I think. Alright. Kissing booth? No? Oh well. Lots of bombs in this one, though. Well, more bombs than there were last time. Alright, so here's what I'm going to do, since there's no kissing booth. Hopefully that doesn't make him mad. Okay. I'm going to go on ahead and buy a shotgun, just so I already have one when the shopkeepers get mad at me. And I might be able to just attack him without having to waste a bomb. Yeah, there we go. Good, good, good. Yeah, that's a terrible position for a tiki man. Ah, oh, fuck off, man. I'd recommend Banner Saga if you like strategy-based RPGs. Yeah, I've heard good things about that game. It looked pretty cool from what I've seen of it. I do like strategy RPGs. I'm just not particularly good at them. Aw, man. The Tiki Man messed up all my plans. Oh well. Oh god! Crap, I probably should have just shot that guy. Okay. I'm sure time is running out at this point, but I got the Ankh. Is there anything in that shop I need? No, not really. Man, there's still a bunch of shopkeepers down there, too. Alright, see if I can just slip past them. Oh god. Ooh, we're running out of time. Okay. I think it's safe. Well, relatively safe. In this game, relatively safe is about the best you'll ever get. I don't think buying an early access game is a very smart choice, except if you're really impatient or really want to search for bugs to help out. It depends. I mean, Nuclear Throne was technically an early access game, but I feel like I got my money's worth out of it already, even though it's not done yet. But yeah, there are definitely early access games that that I would not spend my money on. I wish I was doing a little better as far as my health goes. Well, if I can take this shopkeeper out, then I can get this damsel. I want to drain that fish tank first, so I don't have to deal with piranhas. Oh god! This really reminds me of music from Charlie Brown, the animated TV series, or the animated movies. You're a jerk, you know that guy? Forget it, I'm just not gonna worry about the damsel. That's a really bad layout. I don't know, Duke, you're paying for a buggy, unfinished game. Why ruin the experience? I don't think Nuclear Throne was buggy. Well, I mean, it wasn't buggy in my experience. Sure, it was unfinished, but, you know, it took me a good few hours to make it to the end of that game, or what was the end at the time I played it. But, I mean, really, it just depends on the game. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and lock the bets. Thank you, Tarka, for reminding me. But yeah, in general, I think that early access is a trend that you kind of have to watch out for. You have to be a little cautious when it comes to early access. Alright, feeling pretty good about my bomb count at this point. Ooh, feeling even better about my bomb count now. Wow. Oh, fuck! I got caught on the wall because of my climbing gloves. Okay, well, stream's not over. I still have a chance to turn this into an Olmec kill. Climbing gloves can be a risky proposition, but they're way too useful for me to pass up, personally. A lot of big streamers will pass them up, just because of situations like that, where they, you know, being sticky is not always to your advantage in this game. Minecraft turned out well, but I consider it the exception. Yeah. And I mean, even Minecraft, you know, when it first came out, there was hardly anything to that game. I mean, go back and play, I don't know if they still make it available, but for a while they had the original Minecraft available as a free Java applet on their website, and it was pretty bare bones. And from what I understand, that's what Minecraft was the first time it was sold. There might have been a little bit more to the version that was for sale, but it was not nearly as robust as the game that's out today. So, I mean, really what I would recommend anyone do is watch videos of the game first. Like, try to get a feel for how much is in the game at the moment before you decide to make the purchase or not. Alright, so I think four of those Yetis, of the dead Yetis, will be enough to get me the Kapala, which I should be able to find around here somewhere. I think it's four. Might be eight. If it's eight, I might be out of luck. I forget where I put my shotgun down. I should probably pay more attention. Ah, there we go. Excellent. It was four. Alright, well, it's a bummer that this won't be a hell run, but, oh, there it is. But, you know, if I turn this into another Olmec victory, then, well, for one, I will actually win, at Spelunky Roulette for once. Which would be nice, since I am running pretty low on funds at the moment. Spelunky bucks. Minecraft today is such a huge package of stuff, so many mods and things. Yeah, Minecraft is, it's turned into quite a beast. Quite a beast of a game. Aw, man. Damsel's already dead. Oh well. I was watching a stream where the damsels were all pugs. Because you have the option, you can do the lady, the dude, the dog, or a random mix of all three. And someone had just dogs. And when they had the Kapala, they referred to whipping the dog to get its blood. They referred to that as juicing the dog, which I thought was pretty disgusting slash hilarious. I was thinking about switching to just dogs just for that purpose, so I can juice the dogs. It's so gross. Oh god. Alright. Let's create a nice little bottomless pit for you to fall in. Or blow you up. Blowing you up would be nice too. I mean, we have plenty of bombs, so That's one of the mistakes I make a lot that I need to stop doing is being too stingy with the bombs. Like, I'll make it to hell with like 30 bombs and I'll still want to conserve them, even though that's what having that many bombs is for. I'll be like, no, I have to save every last bomb just in case I need them. What happens if you actually run out of currency for betting? I don't know. I haven't run out yet, and I haven't seen someone run out, so I don't know what happens. Okay, well, don't have to worry about City of Gold, so I don't necessarily have to worry about killing Anubis, unless he gets in my way. Oh crap, I triggered that crocodile, man. That ended in disaster the last time it happened. By the way, Duke, have you seen or played Our Darker Purpose? It's sort of Binding of Isaac. I've heard the name. I didn't know what it was, so no. Wait. Was that trap triggered? I know. Okay, I guess it was. Oh, I see the arrow now. Okay. I do enjoy Binding of Isaac quite a bit, so I'll be sure to take a look and see what it's all about. Hopefully it won't be that much longer until Binding of Isaac Rebirth comes out. Ideally, it would come out right after I get all the achievements in this game. This is my favorite track on the album, I think. The Cool Caves. Really, really great piece of music. Yeah, I think roguelikes, well, action roguelikes specifically, are my new favorite genre of game. It used to be platformers, so Spelunky, as an action roguelike platformer, is like the ultimate game for me. But in general, I think action roguelikes, like Spelunky, and The Binding of Isaac, and Nuclear Throne, and Eldritch, stuff like that. I think that's become my new genre of choice. And don't get me wrong, I still love all kinds of platformers. Metroidvanias especially are one of my faves. But I don't know. Like, I've gotten into The Binding of Isaac and Spelunky in a way that I never got into any other game before. Like, they've just provided me with so much enjoyment. Alright, let's try to just slip past. Oh god! Whew, that was close. That thing almost knocked me into that tiki trap. Alright. Oh my god! Wow, that was close. Hello, Lelouch Hero. It's a grim, darky game like Binding of Isaac, while it's a bit more slow-paced. Huh. I mean, the grim darkness of Isaac, it didn't really, that wasn't the thing that I really liked about it. I mean, I like the aesthetic of that game fine, but yeah, it's not my, I played it for the mechanics, you know. I do like the 8-bit look. Oh wait, this is the Cool Caves. This is my favorite track. That last track was crap, I forget. But I really like both tracks. But this is my favorite. I don't know why I'm going through this, since I'm not going to hell, and I have plenty of resources. But, you know, it's tradition. Alright, well, since I don't have to worry about getting to the hell door, I can just bomb anywhere, I guess. So, I'll just, get Olmec to chill over here for a minute. Finding of Isaac wore off quickly for me. I think I watched too many streams and LPs of it, though. See, I watch people play it. I played it myself. I listened to people play it while I played it. I got super into that game. And I don't usually get obsessed with a game like that. It's pretty uncommon for me. Bye, Olmec. See, that's where the hell door is, if I had the Book of the Dead. But unfortunately, I do not. Alright, well, congratulations, Duke of the Bump, for another satisfying on-stream Spelunky victory. I don't know why I'm congratulating myself in the third person, but seemed appropriate. That reminds me, I haven't watched that eggplant run, or whatever it was called. That is a really good run. You can skip a lot of the early part of the game, because a lot of it is ghost mining, which is really boring to watch. But once he gets to the mothership, that's when it starts to get good. Alright, well, now the question is, did anyone bet on me to win? Did anyone have faith in me? Doesn't look like it. Alright, well, sorry everyone. Alright, see how much money I got for this. 100. That's pretty good. Alright, I mean, I don't blame you for not betting on me to win, since, you know, most likely, I was trying to go to hell, so if I did get to Olmec, I probably would have died to something else. But, okay, bets are open for the next round. I will take a brief break for you guys to get your bets in and for me to take care of something. Be right back. Returned. Still have another hour before I can do the daily, so let's give hell another shot. I know it's a little anticlimactic for me to do just a normal run after a successful stream, but you know, it's too early to call it quits. I learned recently that these hash marks on the wall actually change the more you play. like, the number of deaths you have adds hash marks to the wall. I think it stops at 1,000, though. Because there are 24. There are 100 hash marks on the wall, and I think each one represents 10 deaths. Because I have, I can't get to my stash from here. I have, like, 1,200 deaths or something at this point, and it hasn't updated since then. Great run, GG. Thank you. I feel pretty good about that. Now I only have to beat Olmec about 1,190 more times to get my kill-death ratio back to 1-to-1. I probably should have seen that. Oh well. Well, it makes sense that I have a successful run and then I take a bunch of damage in the stupidest ways possible. Because, I mean, you have to balance it out. But it's okay because I've gotten to the point where I can get knocked down to 1 health and still have a successful run. Not worth looking up there. One thing I've seen some Spelunky players do is they'll start a new save file and start over from zero with zero wins, and they'll see how far they can go on one save before they die. Which that might be a fun way to play once I get good enough to beat Hell. Just start a new save file and see how many times in a row I can go. I don't know. I mean, I had fun watching that because the player was pretty good, but I don't know if that's something you guys would enjoy. Wow, I can almost buy the cape and the gloves. Let's get the gloves first, and if I get enough money, I'll come back for the cape. Wow, that is exactly enough. That was a well-placed gem. Is it just me, or the stream seems kind of dark? Dark how? I mean, it looks normal to me, but the screen brightness. Does that help? Now it's a little bit too bright. I hope I don't have something that's like affecting the capture software or something. Yeah, it looks like a dim screen. Oh, hey, Misty Shade, what's up? Huh, I don't know. I recorded a test video before I started streaming, but that was mostly just to check the audio levels, so I didn't really notice anything different about the brightness. So I learned recently, I never knew this before, but in addition to buying a kiss, if you pick the damsel up before you hit the buy button, you can actually buy the damsel, which you can then use to sacrifice or take to the exit like normal. And if I get enough money, I might actually do that since there's an ultra on this level. Not much working while I watch. I hear ya. I wish I could watch streams while I was at work. I mean, I probably could, but they don't really want us using too much bandwidth. So I might get in trouble for it. I'm wondering if it's a text overlay on the stream that's causing it. Well, let me, That... Oh, you know what? I kind of see what you mean now. With the brightness. Huh. I don't think removing the text overlay did anything. Let me try deleting it. Huh, that's weird. Let me try putting... Try just deleting this layer and then adding it back. Oh, oops. That looks better actually. Let me turn the brightness back down. Back to the normal setting. Oh wait, I just hit X for default settings. There we go. Alright. That looks better to me. How does it look to you guys? I guess the text isn't really that vital. I pretty much just put it up there to stave off questions about Spelunky Roulette. Now it's good, much better. Huh. That's weird. Don't know why I did that. It doesn't look like I have enough to buy that damsel. How much was it? Like 15,000, right? Well, let's try, I'm gonna have to use several ropes to get back up there, too. That's kind of a shame. But you know, it's worth it if I get something good from the altar and later on, you know, have a chance of getting the Kabbalah. That's worth spending a few ropes on. I think I have enough now. Oh, wrong way. Yeah, sorry about that. I didn't think to. Oh, it was only 12,000. Okay. It must be. I mean, like anything, I'm sure it gets more expensive in later levels, which is what I was thinking of. Of course, considering that I only have one hit point, maybe it would have been wiser for me to just sacrifice the damsel. Huh. Okay, so what killed me? I threw the torch and broke a pot open, and I died. There must have been an enemy in the pot. But what kind of enemy was it? You guys didn't see before I died, did you? I don't know. Don't know what kind of enemy it was. I mean, it was probably a spider, but it could have been one of the snakes as well. I don't want to cheat anyone out of their bet, so I'm just not going to count that one. So, I unlock the bets again, if anyone still wants to add their bet. Sorry about that. Feels a little bit cheap, but I still don't know exactly what killed me, so. And there were people who bet on, Kasha bet on the acid snake and the spider. So, you know, I don't want to potentially cheat him out of something. Ah! Hmm. That was a bad move. I mean, I guess I could. I mean, if it was an acid snake or a spider, then I'm cheating Kasha out of it anyway. But it could have been a regular snake, so. Too close to call. Too bad I don't have an instant replay cam. But I don't think that would help. Cause I think whatever it was hit me and then immediately died because I saw a spray of blood. I have a little bit of a runny nose tonight, so apologies if you can hear me sniffing. I'm trying to move away from the mic to sniff, but I'm not sure if it's audible or not. Speaking of audible, how about that big football game, guys? Huh? Am I right? Boy, one of the teams sure clobbered the other team. That was quite a game. I didn't watch it, but I understand it was quite a game. I was hoping there would be a way to get over to that altar, because I hear a damsel. I don't know where she is, but oh well. Oh, there she is. It'd take too many bombs and ropes for me to go all the way around, so forget it. There was much sportsing where one sports did much more sports than the other. Indeed. See, I actually think the football, mechanically, is a pretty interesting game. I mean, it can be fun to watch. The problem is, I don't have a team to get invested in, since West Virginia doesn't have an NFL team. So for me, professional football, you know, there's no one for me to root for, naturally. I mean, I guess I could just pick a team and just kind of root for them, but I don't know. I would feel like I would feel like a fraud. Like, you know, I'm not from Seattle, so why the heck should I be happy if Seattle wins the Super Bowl? Have you tried Risk of Rain? A lot of Isaac players have started playing that. I saw a few Risk of Rain videos and streams. Moore's played it once. And it looks kind of interesting. I don't know. I'd probably give it a shot if it came up, like, during a Humble Bundle sale or something. Or, you know, down the line once I've thoroughly completed Spelunky. But it's not something I'd go out and pick up right away. I didn't see the key. Well, I should probably go ahead and get some paste while I'm here. Then I have to go back and hunt for that damn key. I hate it when it doesn't just make it easy for me. Like, I really love it when they just put the key in the chest right next to each other. Makes my job so much easier. You know what? I bet it's probably up in that that top right hand corner where I always get screwed when the key is up there. Damn it. Oh well. Ah, fudge. This is worth using a bomb on, I think. Yep, there it is. Crap. It's worth using two bombs on, I guess. Aw, man, I don't have any ropes. I'm gonna have to be careful around this ghost. We're invited to get that damsel, but, well, you know, I might as well. I mean, since I already used those ropes to get back up there, I might as well go back for the damsel. Pretty sure I can outwit this ghost. I mean, no offense, but the ghost, it isn't the smartest ghost in town. Crap, I think that's the wrong way. Yeah. No offense against ghosts. Is your character Abe Lincoln Duke? No. He looks more like, what was the president with the big sideburns? Crap, what was his name? It's on the tip of my tongue. I want to say it begins with an M. There was a president that had huge sideburns. And that's who this guy looks more like. Aw, man. Oh, well. At least I don't have to worry about the eye anymore. The absolute worst is when you get a dark level and you don't have the eye yet. So, you know, you want to explore, but you don't want to spend too much time because of how dangerous the dark levels are. It's a real mess. Martin Van Buren. That's the president with the big sideburns. That's who, that's the president this character most resembles. Oh god. There's actually a reason to buy the glasses if you have extra money. If you sacrifice something at the altar, it won't give you an item that you already have. So if you already have the glasses, then it will give you a more useful item instead. So, worth picking the glasses up if you have money to spare, which I definitely do after all these scarabs. Not heard of him. Oh, you're probably not, you're not in the U.S., are you? Yeah, Martin Van Buren is not one of our most accomplished presidents. Pretty much the only thing he's known for, actually, is his sideburns. That's not true. He's probably known for some kind of historical fact, but, that's what I know him for. Alright, well, I see the ding. Anything useful in that shop? Ooh, jetpack, yes. Let me add it. I mean, there might be a jetpack in the black market that I can just steal, but hey, I have the money, and I have the means. I have the means and I have the motive. Oh god. Oh! God damn it. Oh, that was an error? Wait. I thought I hit a bat. I thought I bounced off the frog and... it's too late to, bring my Twitch stream up and see what actually happened, I think. There aren't arrows in the jungle. No, it's too late. Crap. Is there any way to hide this again? No, I don't think so. Okay. Well, that has to be a bug, right? There's no way it was actually an arrow. Because if it was a tiki trap, it would say I stepped too close to a tiki trap. I'm pretty sure it was a bat. I bounced off the frog too high, and I hit the bat. Alright, I want to say it's a bat. So, congratulations, Kostya. And sorry, Galen and Tarka. I don't know why it says it was an arrow trap. I don't see how that's possible on this level. So, new round. Get your bets in. I wish there was a way to hide the Twitch stream again, but oh well. Aw, man. I meant to whip that skull so it would fall and hit and trigger that trap, but I forgot it doesn't work that way. So that damsel can take the hit for me. She's tough. That which does not kill you makes you stronger. Whew. Wow. That was close. Well, that was close to me using the damsel. Me losing the damsel. I wouldn't have taken a hit there, but still, that's a pretty skillful jump. I must have bet on the bat too. Oh, okay. Well, congratulations then. Yeah, I don't know. That's weird. I don't know why it would have said arrow trap. Aw, fudge. I was going to throw the damsel, but then I realized he'd probably get killed by this arrow trap, so... Took the hit. Oh, well. Yeah, it's been a weird night of glitches. First we had the, the freeze-up, or the lock-up, or whatever that was. When I died in the ice caves. Now this. Washington, Grant, and Lincoln are the only ones I know much about. Well, to be fair, except for recent presidents, that's all most Americans know about. Washington and Lincoln are the big ones. Let's take a chance with the mystery box. Ah, crap. Wasted my money. Oh well. Sometimes it's a jetpack. So sometimes you have to take that risk. I can always come back for the bombs. Once I get 5,000. There we go. I'm gonna have to use two ropes to get back up there, but two ropes for six bombs is a pretty good trade. IMO. I mean, I guess I could take the machete. It's really not that useful. I mean, if you're fighting one of the giant spiders or something, you can kill it a little bit more easily than you could with the whip. But I usually don't want to whip those things anyway. Trying really hard not to trigger that arrow trap up above me. More bombs. Always welcome. Oh yeah, and you can just immediately take out these spider webs. That's kind of convenient. But of course, after the mines, you really don't see too many spider webs. Alright, back up to full health. I think the best way to take the spider out would be to set a bomb down there and then trigger it. Ah, crap. Of course. Timing was just a little bit off. Alright, well, let's see if I can, I should just wait for that snake to kill it. Nah, that would take forever. Alright, let's see if I can kill the same without wasting any more bombs. This is actually a pretty good position. Ah, there we go. I don't know how many machete hits it takes to kill a spider. I mean, it does more damage than the whip. But I'm not really... That's probably going to crush that skull and blow that thing up. Yeah, not worth the risk. I guess the machete's cool. It's just I usually have a better item I'd like to take with me instead. I still have not seen the chest. One more level, hopefully I didn't miss it. And it's a spider level, great. Well, it can take cavemen out in 2 hits instead of 3, so I suppose it's good for something. Man, I really don't want to go through this way, but I'm going to have to if I want to explore this whole level and look for the mines, or look for the chest. Oh, there it is. Okay. And there's no way for those spiders to get out. That worked out pretty well. Sometimes when you break open those cocoons, a ton of tiny little baby spiders will come out, and it's really adorable. They can't hurt you. They just kind of bounce around. Of course, sometimes, you know, a regular spider will fall out, so it's best to just leave them alone. Alright, end of the mines. Gonna go ahead and lock the bets. Not as many bets this time. But, Those are locked in. See if I can get some spring boots. Nope. Oh well. See, there was an altar up here, right? Yeah. And that damsel is pretty close by. I think I can do this only using one rope. Crap. Take that monkey out before it causes me more grief. Columbus? Not bad. Should be able to get to that crate without using a bomb. This is a pretty precarious tiki trap, though. You know what? I have a good number of bombs. I'm not going to risk this. Ah, crap. Now I can't get up there. Oh, well. I mean, I could have used my last rope, but really want to save it just in case I need it to get to the black market. Sometimes it's in an out-of-the-way location. Not here, though. Alright, well, here's what I'm going to do. Since I'm right at the black market, I'm going to go ahead and use that rope to get that crate. Hello... Guest 2424. Haha, it's Masherin, not spelled right. Yes, Masherin is the name I used to go by online, and you're correct, that is not spelled right. But I don't go by that name anymore, so you don't have to worry too much about spelling it right. I mean, technically, that's still my YouTube URL. But my name still shows up as Duke of the Bump, so I don't really have any reason to use that name anymore. Did I ever explain the origins of that name? I think I explained the origins of Duke of the Bump, but Masherin is a name I made up just because I wanted, like, an original, you know, a unique screen name that I didn't have to put a bunch of numbers after, like 2424. And so I took my name in Japanese because I was a big fan of Japanese animation at the time, and Japanese video games, of course. So I took my name in Japanese, Mashu, which is Matthew, and I took the name of Ren, who was one of my favorite cartoon characters from Ren and Stimpy. And that's how I ended up with it. And I thought it sounded, you know, sounded like it could be meaningful, but I guess it really wasn't. The hell did those shopkeepers go? What's taking them so long? Sorry, dude. It's dangerous to leave hired hands alive. Okay. I guess they fell down there. I wasn't sure if that was safe or not. I thought he couldn't turn around if he was stuck in the web. But apparently he can. Oh, there were two of them there. That must be why. Alright, see you later, Raffarol. Thanks for hanging out. Hope you have fun. Still one alive down there. Rats. Oh, come on. There we go. Yeah, I kind of wish Google would let you change your channel URL. but it looks like I'm going to be stuck with Mushroom for the rest of my life. Unless I decide I want to just call it quits with that URL and switch over to using Duke of the Bomb. Which I also own that URL. There's nothing in that channel currently, but if I ever decide I want to use that URL, I can. Aw, man, should have bought some health before I continued. Oh well. I'm at 4, I should be okay. I picked this name because long ago on IRC, if you didn't have a name, it usually gave you a guest number name, and 1234 was taken. Oh, I see. Well, I mean, there are benefits, theoretically, to having a more anonymous username. I mean, anyone can Google me if they know my real name and my screen name. And, you know, potentially, I mean, I don't think I'll ever be in this situation. But, you know, if I was being interviewed for a job or something, and they looked me up, you know, I try not to be an asshole online. But there have been times when I'm kind of a jerk, and I regret those times, and I try to do better about it now. But you know, a potential employer could look up a comment I made like 10 years ago, well, not that long ago, but like 5 or 6 years ago, and you know, form an opinion of me based on that. Which, you know, I try not to associate my real name with my internet persona too much. But, pretty sure if someone really wanted to, they could connect the two. But, oh well. Life's too short to spend worrying about theoretical potential employers. I mean, I doubt I'm going to have a job where they actually do that. This is a lot of tiki traps, man. Dude, that's why you don't disclose your real name on the internet. Yeah, I know that now, but I used to be less cautious about that sort of thing. Oh, fudge. But, oh well, like I said, life's too short to worry about that. Try writing about video games for a living, you just can't have anonymity. Yeah, that's definitely a concern about that career. I don't know, you used to be able to have anonymity. I mean, just look at Sushi X and all of the old game pro writers. But I guess the times they are a-changing. Is that what you do? You write about video games for a living? That's pretty cool. I wouldn't mind having that job. Yeah, there's really no point in getting money after you piss off the shopkeepers unless you plan to get a high score or something. Senior editor, that's awesome. Congrats. Write about something, Duke. Yeah, I should write more. I used to do a lot more blogging and stuff than I do currently. Currently being zero. Ooh, altar. Let's take advantage of that. I already used the altar once, right? This should be a Kapala, I think. Excellent. Oh, I finally figured out how to do the mummy farming. If I get to the temple, hopefully I'll be able to show that off. It's not about the locusts that the mummy spits. See, I thought it was about killing the locusts and getting blood from those somehow. But it turns out... Wake up, wake up, wake up! Oh, thank God. Alright, well, I lost just lots of shotgun, but I'm about to, Oh, he said write something about Duke, not write about something Duke. Well, I'm not worth writing about. I'm just some jerk who plays video games on the internet. There's like a billion of those. And, I mean, I haven't set any world records or anything like Bananasaurus Rex has. Man, I really cannot believe that I just survived that. That was extremely, extremely lucky. And now the, now the Moai head is on this level, so I'm safe for the moment. Alright, let's rescue you, so I can start the next level with 5 health. And, be careful not to get frozen and fall into the abyss. That would be a bad way to end this. But I get to play EQN Landmark Alpha this week, which is neat. EQN. I don't know if I ever showed this off on the stream, but if you have the cape, you can avoid getting killed by the spikes, which makes the cape more useful than the jetpack in some situations, especially in hell, since there's a billion spikes there. Oh, EverQuest? Is that EverQuest something? EverQuest Neo? That's the only EQ game I can think of. Can you still die from the spikes, though? You can. I mean, if you just fall on the spikes normally, then they kill you normally. But you can float into them, no problem. Man, I hate it when there's an angry shopkeeper and there's not even anything good in the shop. Oh crap. Once again, don't know how I survived. I should probably get the hell away from this Yeti. Jesus Christ. I've been thrashed by the King of the Yetis. Alright, anyone bet on that guy? Nope. Sorry, everyone. hate the Yeti levels. I mean, not only is the layout annoying, but you have to deal with that asshole. Oh well, I'm not going to get discouraged. I'd really like a good run before I do the daily challenge though, just one. Oh, EverQuest next. I think the new version of D&D is called D&D Next as well. It's a weird naming convention. Alright, bets are open again, by the way. So go ahead and get them in. At least I had an Olmec kill this stream. I've only had one of those previously during a stream, so I feel pretty good about that. Alright, I figure this will probably be the last run before the daily challenge, unless I die really quickly. Damn it, oh well. I have gotten a little better at whipping the arrows out of the air. I can't do it every time, but I've done it a few times. It's just a matter of getting the timing down, really. I mean, you have to whip slightly before you enter the path of the arrow. Hey, it's a classic Kirby theme. Rearranged. That's a good piece of music. I really like Kirby's Epic Yarn, the game, not just the soundtrack. I mean, yeah, it was super easy, but I mean, all Kirby games kind of are. But it's just such a beautiful game, visually and audibly. And you know, the levels are still fun. I never finished that game, since, I mean, I don't actually have a Wii. I just, I played it at a friend's house. If I ever get a Wii, that's, oh, that's already been triggered. Excellent. If I ever get a Wii, that's one of the games I'll go back and play. I wish I had a better solution for streaming consoles. I have one of those Elgato capture devices, but I can't get it to work reliably. Such a happy theme. Yeah, all the music is just so happy. It's great. I think the reason I can't get it to work reliably is because of my computer. I need, I only have 4 gigs of RAM, which for 2014 is pretty subpar. I would like to upgrade my computer, and I was going to do that when I got my tax refund from the government, but it looks like I'm going to have to use that money to move, so I don't know how much longer it'll be until I can do any significant upgrades. I think my video card's still okay, so really, more RAM is the main thing I need. I mean, a faster processor would be nice too. Do I still have the saves for Pop Mail? Yeah, absolutely. That game's still ready to go. I just, you know, these streams and videos are always better when I'm into the game I'm playing. And I mean, right now, you know, this is the game I'm really into. And I do like Popful Mail. But I just haven't been that into it recently. So, you know, one day I'll be in the mood to revisit that game. And I will do... I will finish that off. Mark my words. In fact, not only do I start the saves, I actually backed it up this time to the cloud, to my Google Drive, so save is not going anywhere in the event of a sudden crash. Like what happened last time. Popful Mail non-redux. Or redo. I never did figure out. I probably should have looked that up at some point. How to actually pronounce that word. You jerk. Alright, feeling good about this run, but I shouldn't say that because every time I say that, something horrible happens. Oh wow. Bomb box, eh? It's kinda hard to pass up. I could just go ahead and piss this guy off and steal it. Yeah. I hate going into the black market when the shopkeepers are already pissed off, though. Oh, so close. I think it's reduced this cost you. Yeah, I think you're probably right. Alright, let's just give this a couple more spins. Because when the shopkeepers are already pissed off when you enter the black market, you just don't have that much room to move around. Oh, damn it. Google Merriam-Webster says redux. Well, I mean, it might be one of those words that the pronunciation has changed over time. Kind of like how literally now has a second meaning, which is not literally. You know, language evolving. Alright, let's give it one more after this to see if I get the bombs, and if not, then I'm out of here. One more after this spin. This current spin. English is horrible. Yeah, it's not the best. I saw a tweet by a non-native English speaker complaining that that they never know how to spell words that end in eyes, like randomize or, you know, prophesize or whatever, exercise. Like, in the British spelling, I think it's usually I-S-E, and in the American spelling, it's usually I-Z-E, but sometimes in the American spelling, it's also I-Z-E, or it's also I-S-E, like exercise. In American English, is still I-S-E. We don't change that one to a Z. So I can see how it would be very confusing for someone learning English as a second language. I would not wish that on anyone. Cripes. Woo! Well, let's see if I can destroy this tiki trap without pissing this guy off. Pretty sure this will be fine. Yeah. And sometimes you can bomb really close to their shop and it's fine. Sometimes you can bomb several feet away from their shop and they get pissed off. It's hard to hard to tell exactly how they'll react. Still have not found the black market. Really hoping I didn't miss it. Ooh, more bombs. A lot more bombs. Wow. Aw, can't afford that one. Oh well. If I can collect 15,000 more gold, or not more gold, but 15,000 gold total, I'll go back for it. But I have 44 bombs, so I'm not really too concerned about it. This is 2-3, right? Yeah. Buy market has to be here, if I didn't miss it. Oh, I see it. Whew! I thought that was a reasonable fall, but I guess not. Always reminds me of those stupid YouTube poop videos. I haven't seen many of those, thankfully. Alright, I have 10,000. Anything I want to spend my money on before I go all out? I guess I'll get a kiss. Why the heck not? Come on, you knucklehead. Follow your friend into the abyss. Where are you? I don't know why they run this way sometimes. Usually they both run straight out to the left, but not in every case. Another good classic Kirby track. One from the vault. Nothing else good in the shops. I have 73 bombs. That is a lot of bombs. Kinda wish I got a cape or a jetpack, but I guess can't have everything. Oops. Forgot I had the... Well, that still worked. I have the pitching gloves. The pitching gloves are awesome. They're the next best thing to having a shotgun, really. Because being able to throw a bomb straight out in front of you is quite useful. I really don't like being in the ice caves without a cape or a jetpack. So many hazards, like those mines right there. Whew, shit. Alright. God, so many mines. What is this, Minecraft? Get it? It's like a play on words because they're two different kinds of mines. I'm so funny. Alright. My head is never on 4-1. I'm pretty sure. Lock bets. Oh, have I not locked them yet? Damn. I should probably go ahead and do that. Lots of beds for Shopkeeper. Lots of beds for Spikes. Well, a couple beds for Spikes. I kinda wish I got another altar at some point. I wish a lot of things. This is not an ideal run. If I was a betting man, I would not bet on myself to get to hell in this run. Which is unfortunate because that's exactly what I bet on, but you know. See, I forgot I had the climbing... Well, I jumped, and then I was like, oh crap, do I have the climbing gloves? And then, yes, I do have the climbing gloves. Alright, let's look around just a little bit, just to make sure I didn't miss the mo I had. Since I didn't really look too carefully at the side of the screen. That was a crate up there I can get. Come on. Nope. Just bombs. No jetpack. Of course, finding a jetpack in a crate is super uncommon, but you never know. Alright. Pretty sure the Moai head is not here, so let's get out of here. I hate the ice caves with no jetpack. But it's okay, the Moai head is here, so I can relax a little bit. You don't want to get too relaxed, though. Because if you get too relaxed, then you forget that you have to be careful after the Moai head. Well, I could rescue that damsel, but I'd have to use a bunch of ropes to get back up there, and it's really not worth it. You know what? I'm just going to go for it. Well, it is 7 p.m. my time, midnight UTC, so the daily challenge has now rolled over. For anyone who wants to do that before I stream it. Seems like Spelunky is quite a time vampire for you. It's not that bad. I mean, I do spend a lot of time playing, but it's time that I would otherwise be spending sitting in front of my computer doing nothing. Like, just wasting time on the internet. So it's not like I'm wasting more time because of Spelunky. I'm just wasting the same amount of time, but on a different thing. Crap. That's the bottom. And there's going to be a shopkeeper over here. And I don't really have a good way to deal with them. Should have grabbed that shotgun, but that was a very precarious situation. Better Spelunky than Marvel Puzzle Quest. Well, hey. There's a saying that I probably said in the stream before. But, crap. My philosophy is that time you enjoy wasting is not wasted time. And that's kind of, words that I live by. I think I misattributed it to Oscar Wilde or or Mark Twain or somebody in a previous stream. God, I get so nervous when I have no mobility items. Mobility items being a cape or a jetpack. I mean, I have a glove, so it's something, at least, I guess. Alright, Anubis. Where the heck are you? I didn't get as much enjoyment as I would have liked. That's based on the original Puzzle Quest, isn't it? I have fun with Puzzle Quest on the DS. I have no idea where Anubis is. I'm glad I have a lot of bombs. Oh, well, he's not down here. Shite. He must be further up. I've already spent so much time on this level. Ah, oh, there he is. Wow, that's a really bad position for him. Alright, let's take out that thwomp, first of all. First things first, and then I guess bomb my way in there. Like I said, really glad I have a lot of bombs. Great. So let's lure the ghost down here. Let's not set off that thwomp. Oh, does Marvel Puzzle Quest have like a free-to-play model or something? Yeah, I try to spend as little time on free-to-play games as possible. Except for stuff like Path of Exile, which is designed in a way that respects the player's time. But free-to-play games that make you spend money on energy or are impossible if you don't spend money, then those aren't the best games to spend your time on. Like Candy Crush Saga, I had that game on my phone briefly because it seemed like an okay Bejeweled clone, and I do like Bejeweled, but yeah, that game is abusive with its mechanics. Path of Exile seems mostly fair. Path of Exile is very fair because all of the microtransactions in that game are for cosmetic stuff. There are no pay-to-win mechanics or pay for energy so you can keep playing mechanics. No bullshit like that. Free-to-play games are so depressing. They are just the most cynical type of video game imaginable. They're like, how do we sponge as much money out of people as possible? When games were designed with that in mind, then the game's not going to have fun mechanics. Because a fun free-to-play game does not make money. Well, I don't know. I mean, Path of Exile might make money. Somehow I doubt they make as much money as the Candy Crushes and the Farmvilles and all that. But Yeah, that's it's a disturbing trend. Oh, thank God. The shopkeepers are already dead. Sorry if I'm being a little overly cautious here. There are lots of true free-to-play games. Path of Exile, Dota, Might and Magic, Duel of Champions, Hearthstone. Yeah, Hearthstone seems, I'm bad at that game, but it seems like a good, one of the good free-to-play games. Alright, Olmec fight coming up. I'm going to take a take a quick break, you can probably figure it out. I'll be right back. Sorry about that. I've had quite a bit of water recently. Alright, is this the first time I've made it to Olmec with the Book of the Dead during a stream? I think it might be. This should be exciting. See, as much of a time sink as Spelunky is for me, I do not feel bad about any of the time I spend in this game, because it has been completely satisfying from beginning to end. You know, I play a lot. Another shotgun, thanks. I play a lot. I improve. I gradually make it farther and farther. That was a very dangerous jump. Still no jetpack or cape. If I keep complaining about that loudly enough, eventually the game will give me one. Well, spring shoes, that's actually helpful. I mean, remember that one stream where I said, I pretty much asked the game straight out to give me a jetpack, and it immediately did? Good times. Alright, pretty sure that's all the crates up here. There were not that many. Alright, let's figure out where the hell door is. You can tell where the hell door is because the Book of the Dead, the mouth will start moving faster, which means it is right here. So let's, crap. Let's drop a rope. Let's see where Olmec ends up. Okay. So I want to bomb right beside the huge stone tablet on the ground there, in the background. It's very important that you get Olmec aligned properly before you continue on this path. I don't know how to get the bomb to fall straight down. I see people do that in streams. Like, they place one bomb immediately after the other, and the second bomb just drops straight down. But, I'm not sure how to get it to do that. Gotta be careful not to get too close. Alright, let's bomb this little ledge here. And I think that's good. Well, I should probably bomb this section as well. Let's get that just to be on the safe side. I have plenty of bombs. Alright. I think that's good. Oh, come on. Damn it, Olmec. Ah, crap. I did not align it correctly. Which means I'm either gonna have to use more bombs or make Olmec stomp to realign himself. And making him stomp isn't the safest thing in the world. But I'm going to try that. I'm not gonna get him to do it. Great. Alright, well, let's spend a few more bombs. I still have a good number. You get 24 bombs immediately as soon as you enter Yama's chamber, assuming that you have either a shotgun or at least one bomb when you go in. Alright, this is turning into a very wide chasm. Alright, come on, Olmec. Don't be a jerk. Thank you. Round of applause, please. First time I made it to hell during a stream. A horrible feeling of nausea comes over me, but you know, I feel pretty good. I mean, I could feel better, since I don't have a lot of the items I would normally want during a hell run. But you know, feel pretty good about my progress. Alright, let's find a safe place to stand down here. Should be able to stand right here. In fact, let's go on ahead and take that out. I didn't know the spike ball would go flying like that, though. Alright, if I can kill that Dracula, then, oh, never mind. I don't need to kill that Dracula. Alright, I have a cape, which is better than nothing. In fact, I mean, like I was saying, a cape is actually a really good item to have in hell, because it enables you to deal with spikes much more easily. Alright, see if I can take the shopkeeper out using my trick. Sometimes it works for me, sometimes it doesn't. Nope, did not work. Let's try one more time. I think I got him. Yes, excellent. Alright, let's get out of here as quickly as possible. Go, Duke, thank you. I might not talk as much because since I actually made it to hell, I kind of want to focus. But you know, in the end, it is just a video game, so if I do end up dying, which is possible, I'm not going to lie, if I do end up dying, I am not going to fret over it too much. Alright, I tried to bomb that Dracula, but wasn't able to, but still ended up working out. See, normally, those tiki traps, there are a couple that spawn right next to the exit. So the shopkeeper pretty often isn't an issue in hell, but I got unlucky on the last level. Oh god. That was too close. Too close. You don't want to get too close to the damsels in hell, because one of them is going, I think there's two in every hell level, and one of them is actually a succubus. So not worth the risk. Crap! Just can't give me a break with that shopkeeper, can they? Oh, he got hit by that, the spike ball. Let's, see if we can take him out from down here. See if we can get a few lucky shots in. Spray and pray. Yep, got him. Alright. It's getting intense. Oh god. Oh crap. Can I not jump on those guys' heads? I might not be able to since they have spikes on their heads. I didn't consider that. Yama's chamber with one hit point. Yama's throne, rather. Alright, it's another first for the stream. Alright, let's immediately throw a bomb at these guys. Take out horse head and ox face. Probably should have just shot them so I wouldn't have these gaping holes. Don't. Oh crap! I think, well, I made it to Yama. See, the last time I made it to Yama, I just threw bombs at Horsehead and Oxface and just blew them up because I didn't have the pitching gloves. So, you know, the bomb went in a nice little arc and I didn't blow a hole in the floor or anything. That time I had the pitching gloves. I should have just shot them with a shotgun. I wanted to take them out as quickly as possible since I only had one hit point. Oh well. Lesson learned for next time, I guess. Nobody bet on lava, sadly, so sorry to everyone who lost their bet. Does it differentiate between Lava and Lava Man? Oh, it's Magma Man. Well, nobody bet on either one, so it doesn't really matter. Alright, well, thanks to everyone wishing me a good game. Made it to Yama. That is a step in the right direction. What do those enemies do? Oxface and whatever. You know, I always kill them before they could do anything. They each drop a bomb crate. That's one thing that they do. Alright, let's do a daily challenge. I restarted the best, right? Yeah, okay. Alright, remember that on a daily challenge, my goal is to get as much gold as possible, so my strategy is going to be mostly the same. I probably won't be going all the way to hell, simply because I'd rather have the 50,000 gold you get for beating Olmec and leaving. So yeah, I would not advise you to bet on hell because I will probably not go that far in this run. Funny enough, I think in Chinese it's ox head and horse face. Oh really? Oh, that might be what it is in English. I might have it backwards. I'm not sure. I thought it was horse head and ox face. Ah, crap. I should have just bombed there. Well, I can still get to that crate. But Man, it, you know what? It got really cold in here all of a sudden. I'm kind of shivering. Let me put a sweater on. Hold on. Sorry about that. Is Yama a Chinese folklore figure? I wasn't entirely sure if he was based on anything or not. Oh, for fudge's sake. And a ruby. Oh, and another ruby. Good value. Alright, that was a pretty good level. Now, what I'm going to have to do is not do something that has screwed me on previous daily challenges and try to steal from the shops. I'll be doing a daily challenge and I'll come across a shop with like 3 bomb boxes. And I'm like, man, that's too good of a deal to pass up. But I don't want to spend all this money. I can probably deal with the shopkeepers. And, that is usually not the case. Actually, I don't know where there it is. There's a jetpack. Now, like I said, I did figure out how to steal from the shopkeepers, only taking 1 point of damage. It's not easy. You have to be quick. You have to quickly whip them, jump on their head, and then pick up the shotgun. I've seen people do it without taking any damage. I don't know how to do that. But, it's not worth it. Not during a live stream. Crosses through Hindu and Buddhist stuff to Chinese, I believe. Oh, interesting. Is Kali an actual deity? I kind of assumed all the mythology in this game was made up. Because, I mean, it crosses several different types of culture. I mean, you have, like, I don't know what the Tiki Men would be, like, Amazonian culture or something. And you have like Mayan culture with Olmec, and well, I mean, I guess Olmec is real, so it would stand to reason that the other deities would be real as well. Let's see if I can find something to pick up to trigger that trap. I don't think so, but there's a ruby over here. Might be able to get that crate. I don't know. Alright, I could try to whip the arrow, but daily challenge, live stream, going to play it safe. See, the reason I was able to make it to Yama in that last playthrough is because I was playing it very safe. I wish I was playing it safer, so I made it there with more than 1 health, but usually the way you screw yourself over in this game is taking dumb, unnecessary risks. I'd have to use 2 ropes to get that crate. Not worth it. Well, unless I can jump. Yeah. Might be able to make that second jump. Not sure. Yeah, there we go. Alright. 1 rope per crate. That's pretty good. And I do have extra ropes. Yeah. Of course it's a parachute. Why wouldn't it be? Kali is Hindu. Oh. Huh, makes sense. See? Always be caring. Rule number one of surviving the mines. You know what I hate about games when they make the normal difficulty really easy? Seems like a trend with all those modern console games. I think normal difficulty must be challenging. I mean, I guess it's a semantic issue. See, what I like is when games... That's a terrible position for that chest. Wow, that sucks. Is there a way in there from the bottom? No? Alright, well, hopefully this will be sticky bombs. Nope. Alright, well, I can either... Ah, crap. Okay. I like it when games let you change the difficulty on the fly. Alright, that was a stupid, unnecessary risk, but I wanted to try it. Let's try it again. Nope. Okay. Oh, man. Fuck. And I'm out of bombs. Sometimes I'm able to do that. It's called cooking a bomb, where you set the bomb down and you pick it up and you throw it right as it's about to go off. Alright, well, no city gold for me, it looks like. Unless I get really lucky and am able to see where the black market is. Oh, it's okay. The run's not over. I can still get a pretty good score just by going through and beating Olmec. Normal should require some effort from you. Yeah, it's but I mean, you know, you're really good at video games. Someone who's not really good at video games, you know, normal might be the perfect level of challenge for them. So it's best when best when you can change it on the fly, I think, because you can say, wow, this really isn't challenging enough. I wish I'd pick something better, something higher than normal. You can just go in and change it, fix it. Alright, keeping an eye open for any leaves that would indicate where the black market is. Not counting on getting that lucky, but you never know. I wish I could get that damsel out so I could sacrifice her. I think possibly we might have leveled up as players. Yeah, exactly. I mean, in general, I'm not very good at video games, so normal is usually a good level of difficulty for me. If someone is not good at video games, they should play the easy mode because they're not good. Well, I think normal should be balanced for what the majority of players are. And I think the majority of players aren't super skilled. So easy should be for the people who are really terrible. That was an unnecessary risk, but you know, this is a gold run. That's my reasoning for every dumb risk I take in this run. It's a gold run. Need to get gold. I mean, I think if you're good at video games, you should just pick hard from the beginning. I think that'll probably be what's best suited for you. But yeah, changing it on the fly is the is what would make everybody happy, I think. And you know, you could have like an achievement for playing it without changing the difficulty for people who are concerned about that. I mean, I tend to err on the side of accessibility for games. I think normal should be the difficulty that most people will be able to finish. But that's just me. Well, I can get a sacrifice on this level, so I can at least get the Kapala. Yeah, not getting the black market is a real bummer, though. Oh well. Just a video game. For fuck's sake. That was just a bad jump. Sometimes it happens. Sometimes you just get a bad jump. Congratulations to Tarka, who bet on the Tiki Trap. Looks like he was the only one. Well, he or she, they were the only one who bet on the Tiki Trap. So, congrats. Alright, well, it's been a pretty good stream, I think. Made it to hell. Showed off Yama for the first time. Did both in the same stream. That was pretty good. I figured the first time I made it to hell during a stream, I wouldn't make it to Yama, but I did. Granted, I did not last very long, but that was pretty good. Okay, well, see how I did. Not very well. Oh well. You know, those are the breaks. They can't all be zingers. Okay, well, thanks to everyone who watched the stream. It was a lot of fun, as always. Hopefully, I will do another one of these sometime soon. I want to say sometime this week. Not going to guarantee it at this point, but I'll try to stream. I'm going to try to stream twice a week now instead of once a week. Won't always be able to schedule ahead of time, but I will do the best I can. So yeah, thanks everyone who came out. Hope you had a good time, and I will talk to you soon.